You feel me? Man, that shit feel good, man. Not even on no cocky way. Meaning it took me 15 years to put it all together. You can't allow things that happened to you in the past, the things that you tried to do to make you optimistic about, you know what I'm saying, or make you hesitant about the next situation. That's even in relationships, man. It's very prevalent in relationships. Every dude ain't the same. Every woman ain't the same. You gotta kind of get to know each other and feel each other out and see how y'all vibe. You feel me? And then y'all see, you see common ground. You capitalize on the common ground. You don't focus on the negativity. We can always say, "Well, I don't like him because he smoked the black in my mouth. I don't like him because he's sipping on his water. What about all the other great things that I do? Huh? If you judging based off of that, you feel me? If you judging based off of that, then man, you gonna miss out on a great blessing. Straight up. Because I bring way more to the table than just smoking my black and miles and, you know what I'm saying, having my little water to drink. For real. And that's just with life. And that's even definitely with business. Business, that's what I'm talking about. Mainly business, man. A lot of people want to start businesses. A lot of people want to be entrepreneurs. But a lot of people are scared. They in their own way. They can't get out their own way. They let their mind control everything. Get out your own way, people. Get out your own way and allow God to do the rest. You got to put the work in. God ain't going to bless nobody who lazy. God ain't going to bless nobody who just sitting back waiting on somebody to give them something. And you know, people who be, say, "I prayed for." Okay, you prayed for it. Okay, you prayed for it. So what you going to do? You put the prayer out there to the world, but what you gonna do to manifest that prayer? God sitting back down like, if you just gonna sit on that couch, I ain't got nothing for you. I'm gonna give these blessings to somebody else. You know, trial and error, man. You got to be able to put the work in to get your blessings, man. Especially in the music game, you can't. If you think you talented, you think you can rap, you think you can sing, you think you can do right and all this great stuff, and you think you're the best thing since sliced bread, listen, I'm going to tell you right now, it's not that simple. You can't just make you one song and think you finna take over the world with one song. No, you got to show consistency. You might send that song to somebody that's important, and they might say it's all right, even though you think it's great. Just because that big person said it's all right, I think you could do better. That don't mean stop making music. That don't mean stop writing. That don't mean stop singing. That don't mean stop, you know what I'm saying, rapping. That just mean, that's just one person. Man, it's a whole world of people out here, man. It's a whole world of people. The sky is the limit, man. It's a whole world of people. If I always thought, all right, so I'm gonna tell you straight up. If I was focusing on my hometown to get behind me and believe in me, I'd still be in Douglas, Georgia right now. Because I wouldn't have, that was my cap. That would have been the cap. If Douglas, Georgia was my cap, then there's no other world that I'm looking at. I'm just focusing on, damn, they ain't fucking with me in Douglas, Georgia, so I might as well just stop rapping. I might as well just stop singing. I might as well just stop trying to be an entrepreneur. Man, I just one area, one small fraction of what the bigger picture is, man. Talk to your boy. You know what I'm talking. You know I'm talking that real. It's all about you putting the work in. Who want to put the work in? Yeah, this shit is real crazy right now. But I promise you, man, this shit gonna get better. Because I believe in a higher power. I believe in a higher power. I know that. I know that shit happened for a reason. I know that things happen for a reason. Well, what you gonna do to get yourself out of that situation? Huh? You gonna give up? Well, give up then. Let somebody else get that blessing. Because trust me, there's people out here right now praying and putting the work in. Praying and putting the work in. Praying, learning, and putting the work in. Learning from all their mistakes that they made and capitalizing on the good things they did right. And knowing that they can't do that again because they know they fucked up on the things they did wrong. You know? And I'm going to tell my people something. Stop giving up on y'all relationships, man. Stop giving up on your marriage, man. When black folk get married, man, and I'm focusing on that because it's in my heart. The littlest shit make you be like, I don't want a divorce. I can't be with him no more. Do you realize that a lot of men out here are work in progress? Do you realize there's a lot of women out here that's works in progress? You don't never know that you being the great woman that you are, the great man that you are, do you realize you can make that person great just by believing in him, just by not giving up? You feel me? That's what it's about. That's really what it's about, man. Relationships is about work too. You just can't say, oh, he look good or she look good and think that y'all gonna live happily ever after. No. Just cause y'all got an attraction for each other don't mean this shit gonna work. No, y'all gotta, you gotta put that work in. Figure out what y'all, what, you know, common goals y'all got. Things that you don't like, things that you like. And you make it work. Got too many people out here getting divorced, man. Corona really did that shit, boy. You know what I'm saying? I'm just keeping 100 with you, man. There's too many people, they get in their own way. Stay out your own way, man. Allow God to use somebody to bless you, man. For real. Move correctly. Do the right things, man, and you'll get the right results. Straight up. Do the right things, man. You'll get the right results. You can't expect to fuck people over in life and expect to get, you know what I'm saying, to be blessed by it. No. Your karma, everything you did to hurt somebody, it gonna come back on you. That's why when I go to bed, man, I can sleep at night because I ain't never fucked nobody over. And if I did, I made it right. Straight up.
I'm finna shoot up into the yard real quick.
I made it right. I ain't perfect by a long shot, but I made it right.
Alright, be safe.
Talk to your boy while I'm jamming a little bit, man. I'm still vibing with the people, though. And I also want to talk about, you know, what's going on in America right now. And definitely what's going on in Atlanta, man. It's really turned up in Atlanta. It's turned up, man. And I just hate to see my people like that all over the world. But I can only view, because I don't watch CNN like that. I can only view it from my perspective of what's going on in Atlanta. And that's really sad, you know what I'm saying, about the another black man being gunned down. You know, shit, man, that shit crazy. And to be honest with you, even though I'm a strong-spirited person, that shit take a lot out you, man. That shit take a lot out you. You feel me? So I can understand. I understand some things. You human. You human. But you still can't scared to live your life, man. You can't be scared to live your life just because things is going on and they throw it in your face. You got to live. You got to live. Don't never let nobody stop you from living because they throw negativity in your face every chance they get. You got to live. You feel me? A lot of y'all got children. You got to live for your children. You got to provide for your children. You can't walk around life being scared. As long as you believe in a higher power, God got you. You know what I'm saying? And for those who have lost their lives in a lot of by police brutality, you feel me? Trust me, man. Whoever did what they did, regardless if man don't put, you still gonna have to be judged by God. You ain't, people think they getting away with doing bullshit. You not really truly getting away. You just be, it just, it's going, yeah. When judgment day come, trust me, you gonna have to go before God now. So stop trying to fuck people over and be helpers to one another, man. I feel like we all could do, we all got something we can bring to the table. Everybody got a special gift. Some people just utilize their gift a little bit better than others, but we all blessed to have a special gift. You feel me? Everybody's special. Some people know how to, you know what I'm saying, find their gift earlier. Some people find their gift late. I look at Steve Harvey for an example. Steve Harvey was like 44 years old before he got his big break. Let's be really clear. Steve Harvey was like 40-something years old. So if you're thinking, if people, your friends, your family members put it in your head that you might be a little too old to achieve your dreams, then get what, man? You might have to make a tough decision and cut them off.